Yep. We're gonna be playing the street mode.
He what? Oh, hell no. When? Yeah. Man, I told that fool. Yeah, hit me back. I can't believe that fool. The cops popped Eddie last night for street racing. Man, if we don't run, I'm out 3 G's. Right. Huh, I got this. Okay, check it. You're racing in the GTR today. You just can't lose in that, baby. Win this, and you'll have a fat stack to buy a ride. I'll split the winnings with you. Come on, let's go.
So basically, last time I played this was just to... The audio files seem to be messed up. What's interesting is that I played this when I was a kid. On GameCube. This is a PC version of this game. But funny enough, the GameCube version did not have audio glitches that I am noticing in the PC version. Noticing some audio cutting in and out as I'm driving through this game. And everything is controlled through arrow keys. My forward, my left and right, my reverse, or brake. I'm gonna guess that reverse is gonna be in the down arrow as well. I can test. Yeah, the AS. WD is not gonna work, apparently. Pretty sure music is turned off. But okay.
Hell yeah. Here's your split. Now go buy yourself a ride. I gotta go bail Eddie's dumbass out of jail.
Uh-huh, of course. Now, as I was saying before, is last time I played this, I was just showing off that the game could have been better had they actually worked on it properly and more focused towards the racing aspect of this game. Using this car. Now, of course, to unlock this car, you have to do the Iron Man challenges. Doing all three will grant you this car. But if you do that, you skip that beginning cutscene sequence. But you also miss out on owning this car. For now. I want to do a full playthrough of this game. And by full playthrough, I mean slowly but surely racing every bit of racing that I can do. And owning every single car within this game. No hacking or glitching to get to unlock unlimited money or any of that. Our first car is going to be this Eclipse RS. Now, I could easily just go in and buy this one. The GST. But no. We're starting with this. Lowest of low. Mm.
so far and stopped.
Now, the upgrading portions of this game is actually quite nice. I'm not doing any cosmetic because I really avoid that altogether. I'm getting honked at by cars that are outside. This is actually quite funny to me. Wait, what was that? Interesting. So, I have to remember the best way of doing upgrades. Because the upgrading system in this game is actually quite nice. You go in and you can select this part. And that would make the car a little faster. You go in, put this part on. Also making your car a little faster. You can also go in, put this on. Testing to see, well, this is the exact same part that this is. But this might be a little cheaper and you'd be more affordable to put on at the moment. Meanwhile, you can put go in. See if you can afford this part. If you can, go ahead and put it on. We go in. That definitely increases some of our speed there. This takes away, so we don't put that on. Because I think we've already got something like that on the car. So we don't need to put that on. Don't need to put that on. That will help us. And this will help us. And that's all we can do in terms of engine tuning. We have suspension that we can do. We got anti-roll kits. And a pro kit spring system. And a coil system. Put this on to you. Yes. Okay, that got rid of the pro kit suspension. I don't know which one's the best of those to put on at this exact moment. And this is where looking at specs really matter. 202 horsepower versus 203. Don't really need NOS. It's nice to have NOS, but you don't need it right now. 282 versus 282. But this is 4,300 to buy, while this is 4,225. Saving just a little bit. Now this is the part where you gotta kind of watch on what you're putting on now. Sport tires. This would be better to put on. While this is drag tire. Right now we've spent a little too much actually. Should be fine. Should easily be able to make all this back up though. Okay. So a little under 300 horsepower at a little under 300 foot-pounds of torque.
Listen, there's a crew race you should be hitting. Check your map, head over, and take their bills off them, bro.
I think my main focus is going to be on the buying cars, upgrading them fully, and then that'll be basically us done with the cars, basically, when we have them. Now, the best ways of making money. Let me take a look at our little, Okay. We're all good. I don't really know. Okay, we don't have enough to do that. We do have enough to do this guy's. Of course, his name is Brian. And he's got. Wait, is this guy in the middle? It's MR2. Okay. So you want to do their wagers, basically. Because when you do the wagers, you kind of get double what you just put down. Those are skill points. You can get a max of 250 per race. And basically, it's just respect points. This would be a lot better if I was playing with a controller. Almost got it. There we go. There we go. Max points. That's basically a good thing. You get a lot of max of those. The more races you can actually enter, and the more money you can start earning. Like, usually I'm farming up in these beginning races back when I was little and played for fun. I'd explore with what car would do what. What car would start winning me certain races. Because now I can go in and take this guy's wager. Almost double, actually, I think it was, is double, but it should be fine. That's usually what you want. Yeah, audio gone. where? I don't remember. It is. Look at that. Isn't there supposed to be traffic through this? Or am I thinking of something else? Gonna be able to get the max for this one. I'll probably come back a later day when I have a faster car. I'm able to pull off skids. I got a lot of points, just wasn't enough. There we go, because now we got quite a good amount of money now, and we can go in and even take another one of his wagers. I don't think the PC version of this game is finished compared to the console release. A lot of the game is here, but just not as strong as the console releases were. Another bit of information I can give you about this game is another reason why I didn't go in on the NOS is you constantly have to pay to refill it. See, I've just made 4,000. Plus that 3,800. Giving myself a good total here. But we also have to repair. Yes, damage badass. And this is where I'm going to end this first kind of episode type thing here. If you really want me to continue playing this game, let me know by hitting that like button, share the video, subscribe if you're new to the channel, in the comments down below, send some suggestions to mods, games, anything along that line. Audio cutting out again. Leave this little meat here.
Hey, you doing good, bro? All right, listen. You need to get your ass over
those
to
are
the
nice.
Sanction race and pull in some bills. Check it.
What he just gave us is what I usually go farming at the most. The sanction races, because the first one that you do is in a drain. And you don't have to do respect in those. All it is that you just race. Take wagers, increase your money, and then slowly, you just get more and more. Check something here. Yeah, I'm gonna just pause it. Or not pause it. Actually, you know what? We got a little bit of time. I can continue playing a little bit more. What is it? City or street challenges? Crew zones. I think I'm at the crew meets, right? Yeah. The ones to go for is... No? Same locations, crew meets... That's not unlocked it. Or something. Spec challenges? No. Street. I must not have unlocked it on the map. I don't remember. How to toggle your headlights. Like, you flash your headlights at another player. Oh, it's this one. There it is. These are the best ones to go to. Or at least this one is. It's easy and quick to do. If you want to just farm up money constantly. Because you can go in here, take this guy on. There you go. He just took on his 2,000 wager. And they're pretty slow. It is 3 laps, yes, per race. At least this one is. Also, goodbye to your eyes at that point. Just to let you know, everything I'm doing is on arrow keys. I'm not using controller or WASD at this point. Because it is unsupported. Once we start putting more upgrades into the car, it'll be easier to get away from them. go. We just earned 2,000 back. Or, 4,000. My bad. You can go in here and do the same thing for this one. Take his wager. This will be uploaded along with the Boneworks Part 1 episode. Which doesn't have an outro to it. There we go. Made some more money. And this would be basically what you do over and over. Easy money. And you barely have to put in the work. Sure, later races reward more, but these you can easily grind out completely, earning the same amount back every time. I think the PC version must have been released before the console versions. because console versions, you don't get blinded so bad by the sun. Audio files don't come in and out. There's not this weird popping sound in the background that I hear every now and then. In the Subaru, I'm guessing. I don't remember if there was like a big payout. There definitely was, because I've now got 17 grand.
Yo, G, listen, you got the bills.
No, we are not doing those challenges. Okay, garage is what we want. And you basically, I'm gonna, I've already done this. Yes, we have. Electronics, okay. Put those on. Leave what we got on. That should work. That helps. About this. Put some new brakes. Already got some tires. There we go. Wait, is this? Nah, they're all the same. Now this car is fully upgraded. Now we make 400 horsepower with 400 foot-pounds of torque. Now, this is only the first car of many. Now if we go into the map here, garage, warehouse, here's where we can get a progress bar, I believe. Yes. 50 total cars. Not too bad. Ah, there it is. Progress. Well, hello. Yeah, unique cars can have up to 50. There's videos, which I'm not going to cover. Races, 6 of 72. Challenges, 0 of 20. Interesting rating at the bottom there. But the main thing I'm going to be focusing on through this playthrough is the unique cars and the races. We only have one car at this time. And it is fully upgraded now. If you'd like to see me completely play this game, let me jump into the warehouse once again. It actually looks pretty good. The eclipse there. That's the main reason I really don't go for decals all too much. Sometimes it can ruin a car, sometimes it can make it better. This one, however, I think it looks pretty clean. Pretty nice and clean. Especially with the slightly bronzed wheels or orangish wheels. But let me know what you all think. Most of these eclipses in the beginning is going to be the same car with different specs, basically. Like, this one is a single overhead cam. We'll end up with dual overhead cams, two different kind of engines. We got inline four right now, but I believe there's V6s to all kinds of stuff later on down the road. But for now, I want to say thank you so much for watching. If you like this Street Racing Syndicate video, let me know by hitting that like button. If you're new to the channel, subscribe, ring the bell, share the video. If you'd like to see more of this, let me know in the comments down below and what brand I should move to on doing next. Or should I just completely blaze through the Mitsubishi and then move from left basically to right? For now, peace.